You know, when the prodigal son came home, the father saw him. He was an old man, and the Bible says he began to run. Old men don't like to run, you can ask me. Hallelujah! I want to talk to you about the father in Luke chapter 15. When the father saw the son, it says he ran. He ran. I pondered over it again and again. Why did he run? Because he watched the son staggering home, walking two steps, standing still. And the father said to himself, why does he stagger home in staccato? And the father thought, maybe the son will still change his mind, turn around and go back to the pigsty. Then the father ran. If you take one step to Jesus, Jesus takes 10 steps towards you. Hallelujah! Now, why I really quoted this scripture is this. The father didn't even want to know the sins of his son. No word about his sins. No accusation. The son had done all he could have done. He had come home. And that was all that was needed. Come home to Jesus. Where are you? God is ready to open a new book for you. Only Jesus saves. One young man said to me, why must I get saved now? I am 20. Life expectancy in my country is for me 80 years of age. I still have 60 years. I can get saved when I'm 70 or 79. Wow! Suddenly something fell into my heart by the Holy Spirit. Do you want to hear this? I said to him, young man, listen carefully. The border to eternity is never ahead of us. The border to eternity runs always parallel to life. And it can be stepped over any day. You don't even know if you still live tomorrow morning. That's why the Bible says, today, if you hear his voice, now is the day of salvation. You may be one step away from eternity, but right now you are just one step away from salvation through Jesus Christ.